Okay, our next video here in the precision measuring set of videos that I'm putting together for my students and tool usage is hammers and chisels. I joke with my students all the time that they do not want to be a hammer and chisel technician. And what I mean by that is it's somebody that is always banging on something or chiseling something away rather than using the proper tools to get something done. So let's talk about hammers here just for a moment. In my classes that I teach here at Weber State University in the automotive department for both manual drivetrain and automatic transmission, I insist that my students use a hammer that has a head, hammerhead, that is softer than whatever they're going to hit. So for example, I've got an aluminum housing right here. If there's something I needed to tap or hit related to aluminum, I'm not going to use a steel hammer because the steel will damage the aluminum. You always want to use something that's a little bit softer than what you're going to hit so that you do not damage the part. Hammers and hammerheads can be replaced. The components themselves cost a lot more than hammers and hammerheads do. So we've got plastic hammers. We've got a kind of a rubbery tip here and a little bit harder tip right here. With this hammer here. And then we've got brass hammers. I've got different sizes of brass hammers. But if you need to hit, say, steel, if you're pounding on something steel, for the most part, I want you to use a brass hammer. Now, if you think you want to go grab the steel hammer instead and hit something that's steel or iron, I need you to ask me first if it's okay to do. So if you're going to hit something metal, either use a plastic hammer or the brass hammer to hit it. And then sometimes you just don't have a choice. You've got to step up to something bigger, but not very often will you use or need, in my classes anyway, a steel hammer. And of course, they come in various sizes and lengths and so on. I've probably got 50 different hammers in the drawer over there. All right, now let's talk about punches and chisels, uses of punches and chisels. I have both steel punches and chisels and brass punches and chisels. So I've got some great big ones and some smaller ones. I have some specialty punches that are extra long, and I have some specialty punches that are made just for removing roll pins. So there's a whole bunch of different style of punches and chisels. I've got another drawer that has much bigger ones in a set, but as far as care and treatment of punches and chisels, it's pretty much all the same. So let's start with the brass punches here, also called a brass drift. I've got a long solid one, I've got a tapered one, and then I have a shorter solid one. Every one of these have a knurled end on it. That is where you hang on with your hand, and then with, you can hit brass with brass, with a brass hammer, preferably not a steel hammer, you can hit that punch or drift. So make sure you're holding on to the right end. You always must wear safety protection in my shop anyway, but these all say right on them, warning, wear safety goggles, because parts can fly off of the punches and chisels and so on. And of course, there are smaller versions of the brass drifts over here. If you need to knock a small part out of an axle or a transmission, go for the brass drifts first. If it looks like it's going to take more than that, talk to me before using a chisel or a punch to knock them out. Now, if you're pounding on something, especially with a chisel, repeated pounding without wearing a special anti-vibration glove can, over time, damage your wrist and your hand. And so there's a punch holding tool right here that you can get from Snap-on. It's part number PPC5A. And what it does is it holds the punch or the chisel for you. So you just stick the punch into it. You run this threaded shaft all the way in until it hits the punch. Snug it up good and tight, like that. And then there's a lock nut right here on the outside that takes a half inch or 13 millimeter hand wrench to snug that up so that as you're hanging on to this and pounding, that it won't come loose and fall out. So this has some shock absorption in it also. And if you're one of those guys that sometimes the hammer slips off and hits you in the hand, this gets your hand out of the way. You've got a big gap between where you're hitting and where your hand is, so it's less likely that you're going to hit your hand. All right, all of these punches, the long ones, the short ones, they're always meant for just driving straight down or sideways or whatever. You never pry on these one way or the other because it'll break them. So keep that in mind also. And then these punches over here that are for roll pins, never ever use these as a regular punch. These have a little tip on the end of it that will center itself inside of a roll pin and keep the punch from sliding off as you're tapping on it. So that is a roll pin punch. And there's all kinds of specialty punches and chisels available. So make sure you're using the right punch or chisel with safety glasses, safety goggles for protection. And when you're done, of course, wipe everything off. Put it back exactly where it goes in the toolbox and move on with your next project.